Hello everyone, Xenosima here, and welcome back to Starlink Beta Phylus. Last episode, we defeated Wolf. This episode, I'm going to show all the R-Wing mods, because honestly, this is how you get... R-Wing's the best ship in the game because of them. 40 handling, 40 energy, and 50% laser cannon damage after ricochet with R-Wing dodge. Pretty powerful. 40 defense, 50% laser damage with foot bluff, and ricochet while performing any dodge from R-Wing. Very powerful. 20% range when you ricochet shots with R-Wing's dodge, powerful. 20% laser cannon charge laser cannon damage, 25% rapid pretty laser cannon damage, all pretty powerful. Really, the R-Wing is your best ship. Of course, I also have a bit of a problem. I accidentally pressed because we were sent back to the Equinox, so. Some of the cuts, so we've skipped a little bit.
We can now translate Warden encryptions, giving us access to the Legion's communication network.
That's amazing. Have we picked anything up?
We intercepted a repeating transmission, streaming the video to your onboard computer now.
My children, I believe us. The Wardens have bestowed us with a
Yeah. Of course, we're going to change characters. So, I think it'd be fitting which Shade takes this.
She's seen something.
Put her through.
Now, where did I put her code? Ah, there we are. Dr. Wilder, are you there? Fern, pick up.
Carl? Look, I'm evacuating the workshop. I'll have to call you later.
You've seen the Prime. Fascinating, isn't it?
No, I mean, yes. But Carl, the Prime, it's planting extractors. The Warden harvest is starting again.
No, it can't be.
I know. Sounds insane, but I know what I saw. The Legion, they'll overrun all of Sonatus.
The whole planet? Impossible.
I'm sorry. I have to go.
Hold on. We're coming to help.
Yep. Legion Primes. They're really dangerous. Now we're getting to the big gimmick of Starlink. So while that's happening, let's switch to something that will help us here.
Done.
I just need to destroy the extractors, and then I'll find the Prime. You make it sound so easy.
I wish this was actually the case, because honestly, what it actually is we destroy the extractors, and the Legion Prime becomes weaker. If we actually have observatory, we can actually scan the whole area. And extractor down.
Well, that's one extractor down.
That's amazing. I'm picking up a signal, but it's faint. Wait. There's another extractor.
The Prime planted another. So soon?
Of course it did.
Planet called Dirt.
Well, Earth, but close.
More importantly, their flagship has a
planet called Dirt.
Really?
I'm so sorry.
I'd love to study it.
Oh, dude, you should come with us. Look, we're out of beds, but you can just do what I do and sleep in Hunter ship.
You what?
Maybe later. Have you found the second extractor?
Almost there.
A planet called Dirt. I'm so sorry. I love that line. Just. How happy he sounds. Just how happy he sounds and just being so wrong about Earth. Love the vortex gun. Also hate at the same time. And with another extractor down, I believe for finding our first Prime, we are ready. Oh, we continue playing in the shade in the next episode.
That's two. How we doing?
The Prime just planted another extractor. If you can destroy it, I think that should work. But you need to hurry. These extractors, they're doing so much damage. I don't know if Sonatus will ever recover.
Alright. We'll be doing that in the next episode, and then showing off Shade's ability.
I'm so mad! This planet is gorgeous. How could... Grex is gonna pay for what he's done.
So, this is Ian Azuma. And next time, in Let's Play Starlink, we'll be destroying the extractor and dealing with the Prime. And we'll be showing our first Prime fight. Ugh, that's gonna be fun. See you guys then.